All of us have those NRI relatives who settle in US and buy expensive cars which Indians dream about. And we tend to assume that earning opportunities in the West are far better. Whereas the reality is quite different. Actually, the cars in India are really expensive than the US market. India is one of the largest automobile markets and is growing every year. It provides the auto sector with the largest amount of labor charges, cheaply priced raw materials and inexpensive land area. Along with this, they are benefited with tax relaxations and of course the support of the government. Cars are manufactured in India and are exported abroad. Still, they are highly priced if compared with the US counterparts. Car Dealerator is here again to open up your eyes and rescue you from this black hole of price differentiation. Let's have a look at the prices of a few cars sold in both the countries. Mini Cooper sold at Rs. 16 lakhs in the US, whereas in India, it is sold at Rs. 37 lakhs. CR-V, with a US price of Rs. 15 lakhs, in India, it is sold at almost twice the US price, which is Rs. 32 lakhs. Toyota Camry's US price is 16 lakhs and the same car is sold at Rs. 34 lakhs in India. Here are some of the reasons of why cars in India are really that expensive. Number 1. High tax structure. Many cars are assembled in India and their parts are imported separately. This involves a lot of taxes that pushes the cost up even after taking into account the cheap labor which is completely domesticated. So when you buy a car in India, you actually pay 12-27% of excise duty, 1-4% of infrastructure cess, 12.5-14.5% of VAT, and of course, 3-24% of road tax. So if you plan to buy a decent sedan whose on-road price is 10.5 lakhs, you actually pay tax worth Rs. 3 lakhs. If we subtract the tax paid from its on-road price, it would have costed us just Rs. 7.5 lakhs. Number 2. Lower volumes. The number of units sold in our country is comparatively and drastically low. Keeping in mind the population and the automobile sales, a decent auto company sells about 70,000 units in a moderately populated country like US, whereas the same company sells about 40,000 units in a country like India with the highest population of 1.3 billion people. Low volume definitely increases the prices. Number 3. High manufacturer cost. Increased transportation distance, high research and development cost, that too in dollars, and yes, a really pocket-burning import duty are a few reasons of high manufacturing costs. Companies like Honda, Volkswagen, Mercedes-Benz are some examples who prefer importing kits from Japan and Europe and assemble them in India, leaving some scope for employment. Completely knocked down parts attract 30% duty, so the cost raises to the multiple of 1.3. Added to this is excise adjustment, manufacturing assembly cost, profit margins and whatnot. The final cost for such cars could be more than twice of US counterparts. And in this whole process, who ultimately has to suffer? Yes, that's people like you and me. Thanks for watching another amazing episode of Car Dealerator. We have got a lot of mails from you from our previous episode on how safe is your car. We promise to bring up all the critical aspects of the auto industry which common people are unaware of. You can share your views and ideas and stories by writing to us at info@cardealerator.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn, the details of which are given below. You can tweet to me directly at twinklejen25. Wait for another snappy episode of Car Dealerator. Till then, keep rating.